broadcasting for a worldwide audience.
This is Radio Lewis, where the music matters. And welcome to the Cosmic Jukebox. That was a good start, wasn't it? Well, a good morning to you this Saturday morning, or wherever you're listening. Obviously, time is not of the essence here. As I say, this is Radio Lewis, where our music matters, and this is the Cosmic Jukebox. And that was 10 years after, with Bad Scene from 1969, and the album was Shush. Now, that had a really unsettling cover, actually. Always made me think, I don't know if it did anyone else, of Shrunken Heads. And the album I can clearly recall, in the window of the late lamented record bar down there in Lewis. Opposite, that would have been where Smith's is now. And that was under the old Lewis to Uckfield railway bridge. Song itself, well, it's about a seriously unhappy relationship at the far end of love. Now, 10 years after's Shush itself, if you'd like to know, that performed very well. It reached number 4 here and number 20 in the US. And, of course, Alvin Lee was the man himself, and he had much success after parting 10 years after with a roster of top-quality musicians, did blues and rock. And 10 years after themselves, they remain a seminal part of that golden year of 1969. Now, we're going to have a listen now to a group called The Underground and a track called Satisfying Sunday from 1966. Now, I would like to say to you, I think of all of the groups that I've looked for, this has been the hardest. It's been really hard to find much on The Underground. In fact, there was very limited information at all. You're talking harmonies here. You're talking limited local success in the USA. There was a follow-up single, apparently, to this, which also vanished into obscurity. So, why am I playing it? Well, it's good. It shakes along. It's got twanging guitar, intricate harmonies, and there's also some sound effects in there as well. And that clicking would block you and hit you with a stick. There you go. Caftan's on. Off you go. The Underground. Next track up, we have The Neutrons with No More Straits. Now, The Neutrons are a group from 1974, and the album I'm looking at here is Tales from the Blue Cocoons. And the Neutrons were brought to my attention during the very long hot summer of 1976, down in Eastbourne, actually. They were true sons of Wales, and actually I found out they were, that they were an offshoot of Man. There were only two albums from them. This is the second. It was the one I took to immediately. The first album, I'm not so crazy on. I have tried it. I've persevered down the years. It's okay, but I'm not so crazy on it. But the Tales from the Blue Cocoons, it's got a really cute album cover. And everything about the Neutrons is very, very different indeed. They're quite hard to categorise. Now, this particular track, No More Straits, opens the album, and it bounces us in to welcome us to some real treats awaiting further on. They're not all perfect, not by any means, but if you like the album, you will meet it as an old friend every time you play it, even after all these years. Cusky din. the Neutrons. And the first album, incidentally, is called Black Hole Star. Don't get put off just because I say I can't get on with it. You might find that you can, so give it a go. Time for a theme song. Now, I've chosen this time to go with the theme from Gurney Slade by Max Harris, and the year is 1960. The TV series was The Strange World of Gurney Slade. Max Harris himself was born in Bournemouth, raised in London, had an interesting career, actually, this gentleman. He worked on the Mauritania. He was in a number of groups, including Jack Parnell. I think you'll find went on to Sunday Night at the London Palladium, for example. And he was an arranger for such American visitors as Sinatra, when you used to get a lot of the guys coming over from America, and he handled things at this end. And the list goes well beyond Sinatra, incidentally. He also did a number of late 1950s TV commercials, but this theme for this groundbreaking TV series, starring, of course, Anthony Newley. Now, he also provided theme music for the following TV series. Again, I've been selective here. The Gold Robbers, Doomwatch, New Scotland Yard, the comedy Odd Man Out, which I really don't remember, starring John Inman in 1977. Also Porridge, Open All Hours, The Singing Detective, plus he did the film music for the movie On the Buses. There you go. I won't do my Inspector Blake impersonation. But this groundbreaking series is the one. Surreal, still a little irritating, but still really remembered. And it's Max Harris and The Strange World of Gurney Slade. Harris there. And of course, that television programme was a great favourite of a certain young gentleman known as David Bowie. Now I'm going to play now a track by the Incredible String Band called Sleepers Awake from 1969. Now I played an Incredible String Band track, Coyote there, I think it was, probably about 4 or 5 weeks ago. And I thought as I listened to it, I thought, I bet that's a little tough going for people. But anyway, this is not so. This is from the album Changing Horses. And if you do buy an Incredible String Band album, this is just my opinion. I always stress that. Remember, this wasn't the most successful. The Beautiful Hangman's Daughter was. I personally would go with this one because I think it's a fabulous album. It's got loads of really good songs. It really has. It can't be overstated the tremendous following that the Incredible String Band had within those heady days of the 1960s, notably with the 60s counterculture, but also with folk, pitch, psychedelia, experimental rock aficionados as well. Their support did translate into considerable supporters and very, very good music sales. And this album, Changing Horses, is their fifth album, and as I say, I think it's very accessible. Half the album is taken up by the beautiful White Bird, which is something else, it really is, and the marvellous Creation, which is, again, I've run out of superlatives now, but this is an altogether simpler affair, but nonetheless effective for that. Minimal instruments and the shortest tracks. It features some excellent harmonies. So, the Incredible String Band. Sleepers, awake!
Sleepers, awaken! The night has gone and taken your darkest fears and left you here. And the sun, it shines so clear. And the sun, it shines so clear. Oh, awake, for the world looks wonderful. Oh, glorious golden sun,
your song of light you bring.
And when we turn away,
your silver sister moon does sing.
Then once again we face
your glory and your grace.
And those whom sleep still takes,
ta ra 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 ta ta ta, you tell the little birds to wake. Ta ra 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 ta ta ta, you tell the little birds to wake. Ta ra 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 ta ta ta.
Sleepers, awaken, the night has gone and taken your darkest fears and left you here. And the sun, it shines so clear. And the sun, it shines so clear. Send your beams to earth,
giving flowers their birth.
And looking to the sky,
they see a diamond eye,
livening sap and cell. The first lights ring.
Da ra 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 ta ta ta. Push the petals back and sing. Da ra 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 ta ta ta. Push the petals back and sing. Da ra 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 ta ta ta. Sleepers, awaken. The night has gone. Your darkest fears and left you here. And the sun, it shines so clear. And the sun, it shines so clear. Oh, awake, for the world looks wonderful. Incredible
String Band. You still awake? Good. Well, if you're not, I'm going to wake you up now. Deep Purple, Speed King from 1970. With one bound, we leap from the incredible string band to Deep Purple, but just one year. And how about this? It's a B-side to boot of Black Knight, which of course was a single. Now, although this track is not a cover, there are many songs referenced in the lyrics, and you can listen for them yourself. But first, enjoy this smashing Ian Gillan pen number and the work of Blackmore, Glover, Lord and Pace. Classic Purple, See Them Fly. Speaking.
We'll be right back.
Deep Purple there. I think I sounded very excited announcing them, didn't I?
Danger, Will Robinson! Danger! No, Will Robinson! Danger!
Danger indeed! Yes, it's time for this week's oddity. Hope that wasn't too cheesy an intro. This week I've gone for the Cadets, Stranded in the Jungle. And this is from the year 1956. Now, once again, we're in the territory of when they used to release all kinds of different versions of the same song, and they ended up jostling up the charts together. So, our we're looking for here is the Cadets, but there were the Jayhawks. They reached first. They actually reached the charts in at number 18, and that peaked at number 15 in 1956. The Cadets version came out 1 week later, and the Gadabouts joined the race, peaking at number 39. So by a squeak, and with the helping hand of history, the Cadets is the version best remembered. Now, the spoken sections in the strange alternative approach, and you'll see what I mean when you get to hear it, were delivered by Will Jones, and he'd go on to sing bass on the majority of the Coasters' hits. Other covers followed of Stranded in the Jungle down the years. Incredibly, in 1974, the New York Dolls, even Zappa, and on a five-track jungle-themed EP, Adam Ant had a go. Unfortunately, that was 2003, not the happy 80s, and litigation from the Ants and EMI meant that the five-track EP was never released, so we haven't heard his version. One final thought, that struggle for the Jayhawks, the Gadabouts, and the Cadets did have a postscript. For all three, it was to be their only chart success. Stranded in the Jungle.
I crashed in the jungle while trying to keep a date with my little girl who was back in the States. I was stranded in the jungle, afraid and alone, trying to figure a way to get a message back home. But I was out of know that the wreckage of my plane had been picked up and spotted in my girl in Lover's Lane. And meanwhile, back in the States. Meanwhile, back in the jungle. The boys in the jungle had me on the run when something heavy hit me like an atomic bomb. When I woke up and my head started to clear, I had a strange feeling I was with cooking gear. I smelled something cooking and I looked to see. That's when I found out they was cooking me. Meanwhile, back in the States.
Baby, baby, let me promise. You know your old time lover hasn't got a chance. He's stranded in the jungle, glad as he can be. So come on, pretty baby, just you and me.
And meanwhile, back in the jungle. And I finally got away, frantic and worried about what my baby would say. So I jumped in the ocean and started to swim, for my chance of survival was getting mighty slim. So I thumbed down a whale who was in my way, and I reached the States in about a half a day. And when I got to Lover's Lane, I was almost dead, but my soul was gone, and here's what I said.
You
We'll see the city's ripped back sides. We'll see the bright and hollowed sky. We'll see the stars that shine so bright. A star's made for us tonight.
Pop there with The Passenger from 1977 and the album, of course, Lust for Life. The Passenger itself, incidentally, was the B-side to Success and recorded at the Hansa Studio by The Wall. And as noted on previous show, co-written by Ricky Gardner, he of Beggar's Opera fame, and we heard a track of them, as I say, a few weeks ago. There is, of course, a strong Bowie influence. It was partly inspired, now this is Iggy's own recollection, by riding around in Bowie's car on tour. David himself played organ, piano, and of course those backing vocals, along with Tony Sales on bass, Hunt Sales on drums, so in effect you also had three quarters of Tin Machine there as well. Now, it resurfaced 10 years later in the hands of Susie and the Banshees for their Through the Looking Glass and album. And it's an album so well worth listening to if you haven't done so already. It's one of those songs I feel, when it's finished, you could put it on again. Maybe why they invented the replay button or function, whatever you want to call it, which I don't think I've ever actually used. So there you go. Donovan, and I've chosen a track here called Cellar of Stars from 1971, and it's from his album HMS Donovan. It is the first Donovan track on the Cosmic Jukebox, Overdue. Now, this little gem predates Meet Me on the Corner by Lindisfarne, and it reminds me of the H.G. Wells story, The Magic Shop. I'll just read you a tiny, just the intro bit. I had seen the magic shop from afar several times. I'd passed it once or twice. A shop window of alluring little, well, you read the story. It's a cracker. Really is a good H.G. Wells story. Check it out. Donovan's Songs, lyrics by Thora Stoll, stands up on its own. It's also pure magic, drawing you in. Such a fabulous voice. The album is packed with gold. Check that out too. Two treats in one. Magic. Donovan, Cellar of Stars.
I wish I could find the queer street, the crooked wee street that goes east of the sun and west of the moon, and out where no wind blows. Then I'd find the shop where the Cellar of Stars sits and hammers behind the bar. For the asking, starlight sorts for the bold, moons he sells for a penny or two, rounded and bright with gold, and broken silver of the sea he sells, and the rain spears and the wind bells. For the fairies, gold of the sun he can buy, and silver flowers of frost and dew, rainbows out of the sky, and delicate morning mist he sells, and pretty new songs for whispering shells. House, I would buy a blackbird's whistle for you, and for Johnny a talking mouse, and a mermaid's tail to swim in the sea, and dragonfly wings for my mummy and me. I wish I could find the wee street that wanders up and down, east of the sun and west of the moon, and very near Twilight Town, where the Cellar of Stars for a penny or two will sell your heart's desire to you.
Now, I'm going to play Genesis and the Music Box, and I've gone for the live version here from 1973 from the Charisma album. But of course, it also famously appeared on the Nursery Crimes album from 1971. How do you describe this song? It's a piece of twisted Victoriana brought to life. There you go. That's what I say. And at this stage in their career, Genesis were rising as a wonderful addition to prog rock's rich canon, and one with a very unique approach. Now, the quality of their live playing is in evidence here, and it is overwhelming. The new musical box itself never left Genesis until very late in their careers, and I'll give you a quick anecdote here. I saw them perform this live at Reading, which I've often referred to, that Reading concert festival that I went to. But having seen it and been absolutely overwhelmed, I don't remember how it happened, but somehow I was offered tickets to go and see them at Brighton Dome. I turned it down saying, well, no, I've seen them already, no point seeing them again, and I gave the tickets to someone else, who then came back and let me know that they actually performed tracks from their new album, Selling England by the Pound, and it was a totally new set. I've never regretted missing a concert so much. Anyway, this is 11 minutes of time in this half world, and we're here, and we're there, and it's Genesis, and the musical box.
Thank you. join you. All your hearts now seem so lovely.
It hardly seems to matter now.
Nurse will tell you lies of a kingdom beyond the skies. But I am lost within this heart.
It hardly seems to matter now.
Soon called the by his bow, and he caught the hasty lass. Tick-tock, tick-tock, on the mantel piece. And I wonder, and I feel, and I touch, and I know.
Yes, yes.
Genesis. Well, we've come to the finish, and this week we're going to conclude with Andy Williams and the theme from Last Tango in Paris. Now, the calming and tones of Andy may not have been obvious for one of the most controversial films of the early 1970s, 1972 in fact, but it is actually totally perfect. Andy himself amassed 43 albums in his career, and he had his own TV show as well, 1962 to 1971. Easy listening maybe, but a man who could deliver a song. Now, his career and achievements could keep us here all day, so we'll just instead focus on this single piece. So, let Andy take you in as I say thank you to Cy for all his work. Check out the Saturday Live programmes following and all the other wonderful programmes on Radio Lewis. And I'll see you all next week. Andy Williams and Last Tango in Paris.
We don't exist. We are nothing but shadow and mist. In the mirror we look as we pass. Reflections revealed in the glass. Don't you know that the blood in your vein is as lifeless as yesterday's rain? It's a game where we come to conceal the confusion we feel, but as long as we're nameless, our bodies are blameless. You but by chance.
For a worldwide audience.